Now let's look at the system response for mechanical systems. First of all, let's draw a free body diagram in order to derive the governing equation. So I have external force F, damping force Bx dot, spring force Kx. Kinetic diagram should be mx double dot. Make sure the direction when you define this is positive. This is positive, need to be consistent with force and displacement. Minus bx dot minus kx equal to mx double dot. In other words, mx double dot plus bx dot plus kx equal to f. To make a standard form, we'll make it put a number first. So compared to a standard form, so make sure we need to put these coefficient to be 1 right here. So divide by 100. So that's 20. X dot plus X. In other words, 1 over omega n squared should be 50. 2 zeta omega n should be 210. And the k should be 1 over 1000. So system parameter should be this one. In other words, omega n should be square root of 50 in radian per second. And so omega n should be omega n should be 7.07 radian per second. And damping ratio should be, this is 0.1, 0.7, no unit. Okay, now system response. In other words, if the system will have oscillation because smaller than 1, will have oscillation, has oscillation. It's because it's under damped system. Free response, free response. So you free response, to get free response, meaning you have to find response due to initial conditions. So plug in these initial conditions into the table or the formula sheet, and you get x of t into the equations plus C. What is the steady state response if the system is a constant? First of all, what is x of t due to a step input? In other word, what is the step response? And since it's under damp, you can find out this one should be equal to Ka. You can find it from the table or formula sheet. This is, should be the form right here. Okay, this is a, this is step response, and K is 1,000, A is 100. So you can plug in, you know damping ratio, you know natural frequency. But the question is asking you, what is the step steady state response? In other words, when time goes to infinity, what is this? Well, when time goes to infinity, these terms will decay to be zero. So steady state response will be Ka, meaning if I draw this graph for this equation, this response in curve, I should have oscillation and decay. This value right here should be Ka, which is 0.1. Part D, the unit impulse response. Well, there are two methods to do that, but the easiest way is if you have step input and then you have step response. So unit input, unit impulse input, then you should have unit impulse response. And what's the relationship between step input and unit impulse input? You take derivative of this one. Take derivative of step input, you get impulse. In other words, what will be the impulse response? Will be the step response, and you take derivative of the step response. So in these questions, they ask you, unit, in other words, A equal to 1. So you can say step response, unit step response. Unit step response will be the same equation here. K times A is 1, it's 1 minus so what's unit impulse response? You take derivative of step response, in other words, will be equal to d dt of x of t, which is the whole thing right here. Derivative of all this in this term right here. Okay. And if you want to do that, B, Ka is 1, so you can always put K outside. K 1 just 0, so minus cosine becomes sine, and minus derivative of this exponential will be minus omega nt e sine omega nt plus v. So if you combine, that would be the solutions. But the idea is derivative of step input give you impulse, and then derivative of step response give you impulse response. And since in this case there's your unit, so that A should be equal to 1 right here.